Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro. Welcome to another tutorial video. In this video, I'll show you guys how you can add stylish looking mega menu which will show images on your Shopify store navigation. And this video is an updated version of the previously created video where I was using Dawn 14.0. So if you are still using Dawn 14.0, there's a link in the description through which you can add mega menu on your Shopify store. For this video, I'll be using Dawn 15.3, and let me show you how the mega menu will look like after you complete following this tutorial. So as you can see on my development store, we have these images showing up when I click on pages, and it adds this grayscale, and it let you focus on mega menu. Similarly, if I click on collection, you can see that we also have some images here. And these are the animated GIF images which I have added from the free GIF provider. So it's looking really cool. And let me show you what are the backend features which you will be getting. So if I go to sections and then I click on header, we have mega menu showing up here. Menu type. And these are the additional options which you will be getting after you complete following this tutorial. And it's basically pulling up images from the meta field. I'll show you how you can create the meta field. And it will also work when we switch to drawer menu. So if I click on drawer menu, you can see we have. So I'll have to enable this, which I didn't enable. So if I click on meta field, because this is for the drawer menu, and then I go back to the drawer menu, you can see that we have our images showing up here. Similarly for the pages. So if I click on none from this drawer menu collection image type, it's not going to show any images on our drawer menu, and it's going to work fine on the dropdown as well. So if I click on dropdown and enable that from none to meta field, it's going to show it in the drawer mode. There you can see that we have our images showing up. And in the drawer menu, we also have the option to enable menu border. So we have this black color border, which is showing up here. We can simply enable and disable it from here. You can see that we do not have any border showing up. And I can also change the image size. So you can see I have reduced the image size. So these are the features you will be getting in the mega menu. And let me show you how you can add that on your website. And if you're noticing that we have some other additional feature on this development store, just like this animated transparent header, this stylish looking slider, which does not come by default in our Dawn theme or any other free theme. These are the custom sections which I have created. So if you want to create similar sections for your store, make sure to subscribe the channel, because I have created a lot of other videos where you can add a lot of different type of sections to enhance the layout of your store. As you can see, we have this stylish looking person discount badge, which is also animated. You can also learn that there's a mark you effect, and here's the parallax effect, and here's the collection slider, sorry, product slider. And so all of the features which you are seeing in the development store can be achieved just by subscribing this channel. So make sure to subscribe the channel and watch the other videos where I have shown you guys how you can add these features. And also we have created an app which is called Big Bulk Discount. This app is basically going to help you add volume discount, tier based discount, and it also adds stylish looking widget on your product page, which will look something like this, if you can see here. And it will look awesome, and it will help you increase your store sales. So make sure to try that out. 7-day free trial is available. Try that out for 7 days. And if you think it's helping you increase your sales, make sure to continue using it. Otherwise, you can simply uninstall. Okay, now heading back to the tutorial for the mega menu. Now let's go to the theme site of my development store. And I'm going to install the fresh Dawn theme, because I've added a lot of customization on this one. So I'm going to install the fresh Dawn 15.3. So click on add. And guys, while this theme is being installed, make sure to Click on the link if you want your Shopify store for just $1 a month. There's a link in the description. If you sign up through that link, you will get your store for just $1 a month. You don't have to pay normal $29, $30 per month pricing. Really easy to sign up. Just click on the link and avail this offer and have your store for just $1 a month. Okay, guys, we will be following this article. And again, this will be in the description. So you don't have to sign up for any newsletter, bullshit, or anything like that. Just click on the link and follow this article. And our latest Dawn theme has been installed. I'm going to click on publish and then click on publish again. Perfect. Okay. Now let's preview that. Okay, here it is. Now, if you see the menu, that's how currently it looks like. And we will be adding our mega menu. So the first step is to create collection meta field and make sure to have the namespace as custom.image. So in order to create the meta field, you will click on settings and then click on custom data. And from custom data, you will go to collections. And collections, you can see that I already have this field created by the name of image. Make sure when you create it, you should see custom.image in namespace and key. If you do any mistake on that meta field namespace and key, the tutorial won't be working. It's not gonna work. So make sure to have the namespace and key same as this one, which is called custom.image. All you have to do is just click on add definition and then just like that. So simply name it image. In my case, it says namespace and key are already taken because I have already created that, right? So the first step is already done. Now let's move on to the next step, which is for editing and adding more code to the latest version of Dawn theme, which we just installed. So click on these three small dots and then click on edit code. Before editing the code, make sure to have a duplicate of your theme because we'll be editing the core files. So it's really recommended to have a backup of your theme. So make sure to have a duplicate of your theme. In case you mess up anything, you can easily revert it back. Okay, I'm gonna click on edit code and then follow the instructions on the article. And first we will be adding the schema code. And where we need to add the schema code, we will find this code in our header.liquid file. And below that comma, after this schema, we will be adding following code. Okay, now let's search for header.liquid file. And header.liquid file, I am going to copy this and search for the schema within this file. Okay, here's the schema. We found that. Now after this comma, I'm gonna hit enter to add a line break and then copy this code. After copying the code, I'm gonna paste the code here and then click save. Perfect, our second step has been completed. So let's move on to the third step. In this step, we will be creating a new snippet file by the name of this. And let's do that. So click on this snippet folder arrow here and then click on add a new snippet and then copy the file name from here and then paste it here. Okay, our snippet file has been created. We will be adding following code. Click on copy code and paste the code here and click on save. Perfect. Let's move on to the next step, which is the fourth step here. And for the third step, we are supposed to create two snippets. That's the first snippet. And that's the second snippet, which we need to create in our third step. So I'm going to create another snippet. Click on add a new snippet. And then menu image custom. That's another snippet. Click on done. And then copy the code from here. And then paste this code here and then click on save. Perfect. Let's move on to the next step. And here we will be replacing the header mega menu dot liquid code. So go to header mega menu. Here's the file. And we will need to replace all of the code from this file here. So just replace this code from header mega menu, copy this code and then paste the code here, then click save. Perfect. Let's move on to the next step, which is the fifth step, which is header-draw.liquid file. Again, we will be replacing the code. So let's search for header-drawer, so that's the file. And now we will replace all of the code from this file, copy the code from here, and then paste it. Hit save. Perfect. Let's move on to the next step, which is again replacing the code from this file, header drop-down menu. So let's search for this file, open this file, and again replace all of the code. So remove currently whatever in header-dropdown-menu.liquid file, and then copy this code from here, and then paste the code here, then click save. Perfect. Moving on to the next step, which is the seventh step. So it's not a mandatory. If you want to have a backdrop, like an overlay, which I showed you guys, you can add this. Otherwise, if you don't want, you can simply skip it, but I will show you guys how you can do that. So I'm just gonna go to theme.liquid file, and we need to add this code after the body line, right? So let's search this code within our file, and after this line, I'm gonna add the line break, and then copy this code, and then paste it here. Perfect. Now hit save. Great. Our mega menu is completely functional now. I am going to go to the customize settings. And enable our mega menu. So let's enable the mega menu, click on header, and then from menu type here, I'm going to enable mega menu. Perfect. After enabling that, you can see that it's currently selected to none. I'm going to select it to meta field. So it's going to pull the image from the meta field. Click on meta field. And now if I go to pages, you can see that our images are showing up now. Similarly, for the collection, we have these showing up here. So only showed you guys how to create a collection meta field. You will need to create same meta field for other post types. So if I go to meta field, so click on settings, and then click on custom data. Then here we have collections, where I already showed you guys how you can create a meta field. So in order to add image of pages, just like I have it here. So if I hit refresh, you can see that I have this collection images showing up, which is pulling up from meta field. So if let me open that on new window to show you guys. So I'm going to go to the back end. And if I go to products and then collections, and if I click on any of the collection, so that's where I'm adding the image, which is from meta field, right? So that's where you can see the meta field image. Now, if I want to change that image, I'm simply gonna clear this one and select any of the other image. So let me select this one. Actually, this one, yep. Click on done and then click save. Now, after a few seconds, it's going to change the image. So if I hit refresh and then open the collections again, you can see that my t-shirt image has been replaced. So this is pulling up from meta field, and I showed you guys how you can create a collection meta field. You will need to create same meta field for pages, or if you want to add it for any other post type. So let's suppose a collection I already shown you guys. You can do that for pages. You can do that for blogs, blog posts. So for pages, click on pages and then click on add definition, and then simply name your meta field to be image. In my case, it's going to give the error that namespace key and are already taken because I have already created that. So that's my meta field, which has been already created, right? So that's why it's giving me the error that the namespace key is already existed. So make sure to create this meta field and upload the image. So if I go to pages and click on any of the page, so let's suppose the FAQ page, and in FAQ page you can see that I have added this image, which is showing up in the menu, this one here, right? Now let's try out the other type of menu which I've shown you guys. So let's try drop down and click on save. Let's preview that. again, we'll have to enable the meta field. So we have currently enabled for mega menu only. Now we will be doing that for dropdown, right? Here's the dropdown. So let's do that dropdown meta field. Click on save again. And now if I hit refresh, it's going to show up the images. You can see that my images are showing up. And again, you can change the size from here. And you can enable the dropdown menu border, which is just for the dropdown menu type. Now let's test the dropdown. We have tested the dropdown. Let's do the drawer and enable the meta field for the drawer. Click on save. And now let's go back to the store and hit refresh. Now here's how it's going to look for the drawer version, right? And it's going to work same in the mobile version. So that's our mobile version, and that's how it works. So guys, that's it for the tutorial. I hope you guys will like this. Let me know in the comments below if you're still having any issues implementing that. Until next video, have a great day.